Hey everybody, it's Cameron Tumman. I'm going to show you some cool and weird color tools for accurate exposure and color monitoring in OBS and stuff. Who streams on Twitch? This guy, only sometimes though. I'm also throwing up these lower thirds to let you know to click on them. And I hate doing the whole like and subscribe spiel, but now that I've said it, you're thinking about it, so... So this plugin I'm about to show you is something you often find in editing softwares, especially programs like Resolve, Final Cut, Premiere, usually when it comes to color correction or color grading. But you can have all those color monitoring tools in OBS directly, live on any of your sources or your whole program or preview feed. So before we jump into it, let's make sure we have it installed. So if you go here to the OBS project site, I'll leave a link in the description so you can go right to it. You click on this download button and scroll down to the bottom of the page and install the one for your operating system. And make sure OBS is not open when you install it, otherwise installation might fail. So once you have it installed, we can go ahead and open up OBS, and right away under your sources, if you start adding a new source, you'll see that we have some new sources, as in false color, histogram, vectorscope, waveform, and zebra. And I'll get to what those sources do in a moment, but I want to touch on the other parts of this plugin so that those who already know what these tools do can leave. So if we go up under our tools, you'll see that we have a new selection that says new scope doc. And if we click on this and we can hit OK, we have a new doc that shows all of our new tools that we can now use and preview. And it's going to look quite overwhelming and we're probably not going to be using all these, but I'm going to go through each one of them individually so that we can understand what each of them is doing in case you want to have it as a doc or you can have it as a source. And if we right click this, you can see that it has the list of each one, so we can select a few that we want to have monitoring, and we can right click and select the properties so that we can go in and adjust each of them individually, and then that way it just cleans up your doc source. And we'll go ahead and disable this for now. And if we go under our filters for our source, you'll notice that we have a couple new ones in here too, and that's also going to be the false color and zebra. And these will effectively do the same thing as the sources, except it just doesn't show as a source, it shows as a filter, so it just operates slightly differently, but the functionality is the same. So the first one of these that we'll start with is going to be the histogram. So I'm going to pull this up, hit OK, and right away we see we have a new source show up like so. And a histogram is basically a brightness scale from left to right, where left is black and right is white. And the level where these waves are at are a measurement of how many pixels are in that area. So as you can see on my image, there's a lot of darker areas, which is why this area is so much higher than the rest. But you can see in the brighter regions, there's a lot more red showing up, which makes sense because there's a lot of red in my background and skin tones tend to be slightly more magenta. And with each of these sources, we can actually specify what source it is monitoring. So I can specify the program window itself, or I can specify just the webcam itself in case I have overlays up and I don't want to see the whole program window. This applies to every single filter we're going to look at. So the other parts of this that we want to look at are we can look at our display and we can actually split up the RGB value. So if we hit stack, we can actually see our red, green, and blue individually. And parade is similar, except it'll stack them horizontally instead of vertically. And as far as components go, Luma is for luminance. So this is just showing your brightness, it doesn't show any color information. And chroma just shows color information. And you can also mesh these two as well and have them overlay. But I've typically found that RGB is typically easier to read and a little bit more useful. Now I don't really personally use histogram that much, so we're gonna look at the one that I do use most often, and that's going to be the waveform. Now a waveform is slightly different in how it reads exposure, but I find it to be easier to read and actually more useful. What we're looking at here is our image from left to right and exposure from black to white. And you can see if I put my hand up on this side, you can actually see those waveforms start to pop up. Same thing if I put it up on this side, you can see where my hand is lying exposure wise and you get a live preview. And you'll notice that you see all three RGB values again, and you'll see that the red is higher than the other two because obviously there's a lot more red in the scene than anything else. So I find it much easier in this viewer to determine where in the image colors or exposure is clipping or being pushed too low, so that we actually have an accurate representation of where our colors and exposure are at instead of relying on your monitors, because as you can probably remember,
monitors lie.
And just to run through these three again, if you go into display and hit stack, it stacks all three values on top of each other, and parade will put them horizontally as well. And same with viewing your luminance and chroma values. Also, color space, I would strongly recommend setting it to 709 because that is typically delivery standard. And if we go to our intensity, this is just how bright we want our individual pixels to be. Typically, I find 50 to be a good medium ground. And graticule just specifies your exposure marks. And I typically like to have each 10% because I like seeing exactly where things are. So that's the waveform in a nutshell. The next one we're going to look at is our vectorscope. A vectorscope is usually used for monitoring where colors are. And if we look at this diagram over here, we can see we have our red area, our magenta, our blue, cyan, green, and yellow. And this graph will tell us where all of our colors are shifting towards. And you can see most of our colors are shifting over towards the red and slightly towards the yellow area, and that's usually where my skin tones are going to be at. And you can see there's some stuff hanging over here on the blue side, because if you look in the reflection of the glasses here, you can see those little bars that are showing up. And if I hide that right there, you can see those immediately go away. And then these lines right here are actually your chroma value bars, but what's nice about this one is this is actually your skin tone indicator. And by default, it actually has it a pretty good spot. You can actually customize where you want this skin tone color if you have a different type of skin tone, but this is generally a good spot to have it. So if you have a monitor or display that's showing something a little bit more green or a little bit more purple than you would like, you can always check this vectorscope and see where your colors are actually at, because monitors will always change. But the vectorscope and these tools will always show the same information regardless of what your display is showing. So this way you have a much better indicator of what's actually correct. And just to show a practical example of how this looks at color values, if I bring saturation all the way down, you can see there's no color information, so everything is in the center of the vectorscope. If I push this beyond, you'll see color flying everywhere and everything looks disgusting. You can also set my hue shift, and you can see it rotate around the vectorscope like so. So this is also a great way to tell if you have colored background lights. You can check your vectorscope to see if anything's outrageously flying off the screen that you can actually compensate for as well. So the last two sources we're going to cover have everything to do with exposure. So we're going to go ahead and start with false color.
My eyes!
It's okay. So what this is showing us is a color display of where exactly these exposure values are. And if you look at this IRE chart on the side here, this is showing what range of exposure these colors are displaying. So anything that's solid red is basically clipped and the information is gone. And you can see that if I increase my exposure here, you can see there's a mark right here and somewhat on the skin right here, where if I turn false color off, you'll see that that spot is really bright and there's actually no information there. So that provides a very easy indicator of where your exposure is at. And the last one we're going to look at is going to be your zebras. And this is relatively similar, except all we're doing is just seeing where information is past a certain exposure threshold. So by looking at these percentages here, you can see anything in between 75 and 100%, you'll see zebras displaying. So this is just over 75, but I can see exactly where that value still lies. So if I increase this to 85%, you'll see that zebras basically aren't showing here. So everything here in this image is under 85% exposure. So nothing's going to be losing texture or clipping. I can also create a different range. So if I wanted to see what was in between 50 and 75%, I could bring this down. And now any of those zebras that you see on the screen are in fact between 50 and 75% exposure. And then just a fun last little tidbit, if you wanted to use your histogram, waveform, or vectorscope as an overlay, we can throw up the source on here and then right click and go to filters, and we can add a color key, and then we can change the key color type to black, and then we can bring the similarity probably all the way down and just bring smoothness up to, I don't know, around 500 or lower, depending on what it looks like for you. But then we have a clean overlay that we can place and do live weird things, because obviously that's, you know, streaming, you gotta be different, and I'm losing my mind. But these are fantastic tools to have if you want to be able to monitor your color and exposure accurately within OBS and live, so you don't have to fix something in post later or re-record in case your camera's blown out or something else goes wrong. Well, that was a video. Come back next time for when I eventually release a video again. Right now, content and streaming are kind of on the back burner because I'm still in the middle of a software development bootcamp, but hopefully there will be more content immediately following. Also, referral link in the description, MAW10 for 10% off. I looked at myself on the screen. This is Camera Tim, signing out. This was my old light.